you know, 20 million people out of 500 products. So I think somewhere the numbers are probably not adding up to me. My sense is really one of, you know, going with what Sasha said, which is, I would love to be able to see this at a lakh or so kind of price point, because the cost of goods in that device is not 5 lakhs. I think you're making way too much profit right now. I think if you figure out a way to cut it down, push the device through at a lower volume, you will really make the kind of social impact you want to make.
Absolutely, you're right.
Love the fact, he said.
You're right, absolutely. We intend to go to around the 2 lakh range in about a year's time.
1 lakh.
1 lakh, yeah. Okay, yeah.
So what's your plan to take this product from where you are to 20 million? What's your scale-up plan?
Basically, we have already a well-established dealer network as well as the partner network, because we're working with almost all the telemedicine companies. We're also, the first year, we are predominantly trying to put it in hospitals, because hospitals are the guys who are going to treat what's going to come out of that. So we need to have a buy-in from almost all the major hospitals. And then we guide them to the next level where they take it to outreach programs, camps and things like that. And that's where we will be able to reach.
So there's an education element as well, where you're educating.
Yeah, that's why we want to go a little bit conservative in the first year, because there is a lot of time between the guy sees the device, likes it, but when he buys it, it's like 3-4 months.
Sure.
So we need to factor all
that. So again, my point there is, you know, you're simply now replacing a device in a hospital. For this to truly have the social impact it can, it should be able to have the ability to be used out in the field by itself. I mean, maybe you put a SIM card in, it can MMS out the image to a doctor somewhere else. You know, right now it's really just replacing another piece of medical equipment in a hospital, so your coverage area is limited to the people who are already coming to the hospital. You want to get that social impact, take this device out of the hospital,
absolutely,
put the intelligence in the device, take out the need for the laptop, and just make sure that anybody out there, a rural health officer, can be able to point it at somebody's eye and the doctor far away can diagnose it. That's when you really make social impact.
We really have that. We want to do it after. We have all whatever you're saying. It's everything is there. What we're doing is in the rollout, we're doing like 90% hospital, 10% that.
So
because
what's preventing you from pricing it lower at this point?
Because at the initial stage, you know, our buying capacity is hardly for 50, 60 units. So our buying, and we have to invest on the mold and things like that, which is capital cost. So the moment we have that, you know, power of economics, it's obviously going to come down. So the intention is that, absolutely.
Fantastic, great. So thank you for
hang on.
The folks haven't given their verdict so far.
Oh, okay.
Right, so it's the moment of truth. Sasha scored from 3 to 10. So Mahesh was quite upset that it's not 0 to 10, but we'll have to do with 3 to 10. So score from Sasha, please hold it up wide and clear. 7. 7 from Sasha. And 7 from Mahesh. 14 on 20. Congratulations. Great, guys, put your hands together for the next startup, SMB Wheels. SMV.
I feel like a beauty contest judge. I've never been one, but I want to be one now.
That's right. Yes, sir, SMV clearly has a lot of crowd support. Is it a paid crowd or unpaid? Inorganic. It's a good strategy. Or SMV. Hang on. Your time starts now.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Mikey.
Good afternoon, everybody. I am Naveen Krishna, founder of SMV Wheels Private Limited. We are working with some of the most hardworking, poor and vulnerable community of India. There are estimated 10 million rickshaw drivers in India. 90% of these rickshaw pullers, they hire their vehicle on daily rental basis, but in their entire work life, they are not able to own their own rickshaw. They are highly exploited by the police and municipal bodies because of their migrant status in the city. With SMB Wheels, we are coming with one window solution. We are giving them the ownership of a better designed, lightweight rickshaw within 1 year, along with the comprehensive package of legal licenses, insurance for the rickshaw, for the rickshaw puller, and even for the passengers, uniforms, photo ID cards. If you could look at the scenario of the rickshaw pulling in India, it is existing from past 150 years, and only innovation which has been done is shifting the rickshaw puller from hand pulled rickshaw to the cycle rickshaw puller. So there is a great space for technological development in this mechanics of rickshaw. We plan to reach 1 lakh rickshaw pullers in coming 5 years. Last but not the least, please support us to enable the most hardworking people of this community to earn profit from their own power. Thank you.
So just to start this off, I have a question. When you say you help with the design of the rickshaw, you bring the design, you help the manufacture a new rickshaw, or what exactly is your input from that perspective?
See, I have been associated with this sector from past 6 years. I have worked with different non-for-profits, funding agencies within 7 states of India. The experience was that the design which was developed from the premier technical institutes of India was really not successful when it was grounded on the reality level. So what we did, we tied up with the mechanical department of BHU, we got their students, and we went with the rickshaw drivers to the different cities of India, especially to Delhi, Noida, Jaipur and Punjab. And we took the best practices from there, and after that we built this rickshaw with the feedback of the rickshaw pullers itself. The final design was, they were appreciated by the rickshaw pullers.
In what way was it superior to the old design?
See, if you could look at the weight of the traditional rickshaw, it ranges from 95 kgs to 105 kgs. The new rickshaw which we have introduced, the weight is around 70 to 75 kgs. So it's much, much lightweight. Even if you could look at the internal technology of the rickshaw, the used cycle bearings and motorcycle bearings are used in the rickshaw. So now what we have done, we have tied up with Bhogal, and we are using the double bearings developed by them, which is really means.
Trying. But you don't manufacture this. It's an outsourced IP.
No, we outsource everything.
Okay, so you provide the IP and then you outsource, and then you create an ecosystem for the rickshaw drivers.
Definitely.
Okay. Yes, sir. We all clear. Great. Sasha.
So first of all, obviously commendable job. It's an outstanding initiative, I think.
Thank you.
It's an issue that has been pending for a long, long time. The second good thing I like about the business model is that you're doing it end to end. Not only just the low cost rickshaw, but the financing and everything else, which maybe at some point you can get out of because it's not your business. The question is, what is the cost of the rickshaw?
See, in the traditional market, you get a rickshaw at 10,500 rupees, but we are outsourcing it on wholesale from Ludhiana, so it comes around 9,000 rupees to us.
So about 1,000 rupees less.
Yeah, that's 1,000 rupees less, which is the margin for the wholesaler to retailer and to the
market. You say you're also managing the financing for them? Are you managing financing for the
rickshaw? Yes, we have designed in such a way that they pay a rental of 30 to 35 rupees. If you talk about Varanasi, again the rentals change from city to city. So we have designed in such a way that they are in the habit of paying that amount. So we charge them 250 rupees per week, and they have to pay it for like 52 weeks, and they become the owner of
it. Take us through where your cash is coming in from. His question is coming from exactly the business. Where is the cash coming in from?
Yeah, so our major revenue sources are, we earn on sale margin is about 500 rupees on one unit.
For the rickshaw, which is outsourced. Rickshaw,
yeah. The interest of the capital comes around 1140 rupees. Plus
interest with capital which you give them.
Yeah. Plus 150 rupees is the one-time application and initiation fee. And we have planned to have some advertisements on the rickshaw, which we have done in the past successfully. So it is very conservative, 250 rupees per rickshaw per month. So it's around 3,000 rupees, and the total amount comes to 4,790 rupees.
So margin is about 2,000 rupees per rickshaw.
Right.
Okay. Mahesh?
So, yeah, I had a couple of issues. One, I'm not in full agreement with Sasha on this. You're getting this manufactured by somebody else to your design. So in a sense, you're kind of sort of a product company. You're also doing all the leasing, because your problem that you're trying to solve is you're trying to solve the leasing problem. You're saying the guy is currently paying a Lalaji 30 rupees a day, he pays me 35 rupees a day, at the end of the year he owns a rickshaw. Then you're doing a third job, which is some local authorities, RTO or getting licenses or municipality, you're doing all of that, that stuff. I think when you're doing these three businesses, it's going to be very difficult for you to scale. You can't be a leasing company and a local authority
interaction company and a manufacturing company to reach 1 lakh rickshaws, right? So, hang on, that's my concern. The second thing is, and I say this with no hard feelings, the Lalaji is paying 30, you know, is charging 30 rupees a day, you're charging 35 rupees a day. The Lalaji charges 30 rupees a day forever. You're charging 35 rupees a day for 1 year, at the end of it, you make no more money. So in effect, the Lalaji is going to make much more money than you. But because you're manufacturing, you're distributing, you're leasing, you're doing all this local coordination. You know, I don't know why social is all fine, but why do you need to make less money than somebody else out there? Why are you an unattractive business?
Sir, very nice comment. And I would like to say maybe it was not clear in our elevator speech. Basically, we are not a product-based company. What we are doing, we are trying to bring technology to our financing. If you look at...
So, in effect, if somebody else comes up with some other rickshaw, you are happy to lease it out?
Yeah, definitely, if that is rickshaw pullers are comfortable about.
So, you're a leasing company?
Yeah, we are the finance company, leasing company, you can say.
So, your core is not the IP of the rickshaw?
No, that is not our core. It's just about making them the rickshaw affordable to the rickshaw pullers.
Okay. So, tomorrow if somebody comes with a television set, you will lease it to the rickshaw
company? It's not about television set. We are only talking about rickshaw, sir.
But you're a leasing company. Why would you not lease everything?
Because this is the product which we have the experience and which we can really sell to the community.
But if you're a financing company, why would you only finance one product? Aren't you restricting yourself?
We are not restricting ourselves, but we are trying to build the credibility initially among this community, and that will come in the later phase.
You just said that the core is not your product, the core is the network.
No, core is the product.
You just said it's not your product.
The technology part, which you are thinking that we are taking a lot of focus on that we are just involving the institutes to do that. But the main focus is to making that rickshaw affordable to the rickshaw pullers.
So that's the premise of the company, right? The exploitation. Right. That you feel that the rickshawwalas had,
right?
Because of the fact that financing was not due to them. These guys are getting 5, 7, 10, 15 years of working, and then maybe right. 30 years of working,
right.
And still having debts to pay, etc. That's the premise of you starting the company.
Right.
So then it's like, okay, I'll get the rickshaw, I'll get the finance, I'll get everything together. But going forward, from what these folks are saying, is you need to know what you are as a company,
mm-hmm.
Because otherwise you'll be a little bit of everything, and that's key. Are you a rickshaw company? Are you a finance company? Because as Mahesh said, then if it's finance, then it can't only be finance for rickshaws. It has to be finance for other things. Then there's other finance, large finance companies that will compete with you and beat you on financial rates. So that's the issue. So going forward, you need to know what you need to do. You've obviously done a commendable job, but you need to understand. To build a real business with scale, which venture capitalists can fund, you need to know exactly what you have to do and a clear vision of how you're going to get there.
Definitely, sir. We'll learn that in the process.
All right. It's time for that moment of truth. Scores time. Sasha, are you going to be looking at your score sheet? Think of the four parameters and give us a score from 1 to 10.
So, I'm giving 8 because so I can justify my... It's 8. Put it up.
I'm the bad guy.
I think commendable thing you're doing, but you need to build a business. If you want to put an 8 here from 3 years from now, that'll be great for you.
Yeah, I'd put in a 5 because I think you have potential, but I think you're doing way too much. All I can advise is if you focus on one thing, and maybe if you're a rickshaw company and that's all you offer a rickshaw solution, it doesn't matter. You can do it through some other leasing company. You focus on one solution, don't try to do everything. Right?
Thank you.
Thanks.
Wait.